Mr. Speaker, sir, I rise to give my few sentiments on this issue of counties spending money without selling. Although Parliament can legitimately interfere, we have to put in a balance between existing projects and think about how we can grandfather in into the new ceiling. My biggest problem, Mr. Speaker, sir, is on the cost of litigation in these counties. Every time, every so often, you find counties that come up with huge bills in terms of litigation. And it is because sometimes we interfere without looking at existing contracts. I think even though as Parliament, we have the power to be able to control these things, the first thing we have to do is to ask ourselves, do we have legislation that can be able to ensure that these ceilings are there before any projects begin? So, Mr. Speaker, sir, in my view, I would support certain of Senator Linturi's statement in carrying out an audit to find out how many projects have really been built and public money have been utilized effectively. Because, Mr. Speaker, sir, this contract is a conduit of a cabal getting into the public coffer and really hurting the public, and those projects never been completed. Mr. Speaker, sir, when we presented our report on Kilifi County, we found that the governor there had spent about 300 million to build his residence. I mean, seriously, we cannot be spending money, public money, just haphazardly. We have to figure out what is it that we can be able to do. So the first step, as I support certain aspect of Senator Linturi's statement, is to carry out an audit out of the 47 counties to see these public infrastructures, how much money has been spent in building those. We can even go further, and I would like to encourage the chairperson of the Budget and Finance Committee to go further and carry out and figure out, follow the money trail or the paper trail, see how, if there are any kickbacks going back to the governors, involve KRA to see on those contracts so that we can accurately stand here and defend any contractors. Because, Mr. Speaker, sir, this burden we have of pending bills is because some contractors, you know, team up with governors and they find a way of ensuring that eventually the governors get money in cash. So for us to be able to feel the pain that the Kenyans are feeling, I would actually encourage the Finance Committee now to do so and follow thoroughly and audit those projects and also audit the contractors.
Thank you. Like-